Hi students, and welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. And today we are going out of the league and out of the chapters we are going to do in the 60-day basic to advanced English course, and going to discuss about the strategy to prepare for the English section of SBI Clerk 2018. Basically, when it comes to SBI Clerk, many students of this course have enrolled and applied for this exam, and they want us to help them, and we are ready to help you. But before starting to discuss how to prepare for this exam, let me clarify few things. That this exam is not going to be very easy, because as we have seen that the pattern has changed, the questions has something new, questions are extremely of another level, right? So when you applied for this exam, you must have kept that in mind, that this exam is going to be very difficult, right? And that is why we are here to help you with everything you want us to do. This course, basically this 60-day basic to advanced English course, will help you to understand the basics of English, and along with that, I am ready to help you out of my ways. I can help you with reading comprehensions, with error spotting, and with vocabulary, but you need to understand that I have my own limitations. I cannot go beyond the limits, and I cannot deny the things my employer has asked me to abide by, right? So let's start about the strategy. And before discussing about the strategy, we have the new pattern. And what is the new pattern? That you have specific time for every topic, like 20 minutes to solve 30 questions in prelims exams, and 35 minutes for 40 questions in the mains exam. So what does this mean? It means that the exam is not going to be very easy. It has to be very difficult, because 20 minutes for 30 questions is very less time. If we consider reading comprehensions, error spotting, glows, test, para, jumbles, vocabulary, a lot of things are going to be there. And how will you do that in 20 minutes? 30 questions in 20 minutes, that is quite unfair, I think. But because SBI means that candidate must have speed. You must have speed to solve the questions, to understand what is question asking you to do. Then the accuracy, you have to be accurate, you have to find the correct answer. And then your comprehensive ability, how well do you manage to comprehend the passage of reading comprehension in the specific time. And then strong vocabulary is must to crack any exam, either it is SBI clerk or IBPS PO or IBPS clerk, but strong vocabulary can help you in long run. So you have to have a strong vocabulary. But if you don't have the four things in you, how will you manage to crack the exam? That is the question. So let me tell you what you need to do to crack this exam, especially the English section, because I don't know about the quantitative aptitude and reasoning, because Raman sir is taking those classes. Basically, my forte is English, and I am going to help you with English problems, right? So we have the things that we need to read. What should we need to read to crack the paper, to crack the exam? First is newspaper. Whenever you start reading the newspaper, the very important thing is that what do you read? Where is your focus? And what kind of articles you read? Because we are very addicted to websites. We don't read the print copies of the newspapers. That is actually very bad, because not everything that is published online is in detail, right? So reading newspaper is very important, that is the in the print form, not in the online form. That is important. Most importantly, you need to have the print forms of the newspaper. Then what to read in the newspaper? First thing, go through the headlines, every headline of the newspaper. It should be related to politics, sports, banking, and business, anything you think that is related to your exam, everything that is related to general awareness. And some people find that newspaper reading is very boring. So what should we do? Newspaper reading is boring. Actually, it is boring. So what can we do? To get a speed of reading newspaper and to get an interest of reading newspaper, what do you need to do is to start reading the section that interests you the most. Like you like sports, then you should start with the sports. If you like entertainment news, you should start with the entertainment news, but for a specific for 5 minutes only. That means you are going to be engaged in reading. After you are engaged in reading, then you should shift to other sections like politics, editorials, and banking and business. So this is the way to be engaged in the newspaper reading. Then we have grammar books. Now, to actually have the command over English grammar, you need to have the basic books of grammar. You can take the grammar books of your younger siblings from class 6 to the class 10th, because these books explain everything in a very simplified language and simplified version. So once you get a book of class 10, if I say, of your state board or of CBSE board, because CBSE board I think grammar books are difficult to understand, so you can take the state level grammar books, right? So when you get this book, try to learn the rules and then try to solve the questions. Those questions you may find are easy, but they are going to help you, because easy things look difficult in exams. Clear? So take a grammar book of class 10 or class 12 and then start preparing the grammar rules and solving the questions. After you do this, then comes the worksheets. Worksheet means, I mean to say that some questions related to reading comprehension, then some question related to error spotting, then some para jumbles, and then some closed tests. But how to do them? You need to divide your time. I think if you are very weak in English, then what should you do? You should actually devote at least, give me a moment, the pen isn't working. Just a second. So I was saying that if you are weak in English, you should at least have two to three hours devoted to English language only. In this time period, your division of time should be like this: at least 1 hour for newspapers, because newspaper is not only for English language, it is for general awareness as well, banking awareness as well. So you need to devote at least 1 hour of newspaper reading, and read as if you are learning something new, not to gather the information, but to gather the knowledge of language, right? Then you have half hour for grammar. Take only one topic a day and then start solving it, start understanding it, and then solve some kind of questions related to grammar, right? Then 1.5 hours for reading comprehension. I'm just giving you half hour to solve the reading comprehension, because you have 20 minutes in the exam, and if you devote more than half hour to reading comprehension, you are going to lose marks, or you lose time for the other questions like error spotting and para jumbles if they are in the exam. So only half hour is enough for the practice, and once you start practicing the reading comprehension in this specific time period, you will gain the speed to solve the questions, right? Then half hour for error spotting. You should at least solve 25 questions of error spotting in a day, right? And this can be used with close test or para jumbles. Half hour for close test and para jumbles is enough. You can do one day you do close test and the second day you do para jumbles. So you don't need to focus your time or to devote your time for both the topics, because they are very easy in my point of view. But if you find them difficult, choose which one you find more difficult. If you find close test more difficult, then you can go for the close test first and then 15 minutes for para jumbles. But if you have the command on both of these topics, then you can devote half hour for close test on day one, and on day two you can devote the time to para jumbles, right? Then you need to read storybooks of basic elementary classes or to high level classes or school level books. When you read storybooks, because we know that there were some questions or RC passage was based on story, so it will help you to understand the meanings of the story, how what kind of questions can be asked from the storybooks or from the story kind of reading comprehensions. These are for your preparations. But to improve your English, you should actually read blogs every day. Blog should be related to lifestyle, fashion, health care and skin care. Any blog you read, you will understand the language. You will get to know some new words and how to write effectively and impressively. You will understand the meanings of some words and you will find some new words. So read, at least choose one blog or two that you write, that you like, and then you should give at least 15 minutes of reading at least two articles of that blog. And then comes the BBC and NDTV news. Watching English news is very important if you are if you really want to improve your English language. It builds up your hearing, listening abilities, and as well as you learn how to pronounce few words that we are actually pronouncing incorrectly. You get the accent. I am recommending NDTV in English because the news anchor are Indians and their accent in Indian, and that is why it is very easy to understand their language. Once you are used to listening to NDTV news, then move to BBC. They have British accent and you should at least learn or listen to one bulletin of BBC news, right? That is for your personal improvement. I recommend this. Then the time allocation, I just told you in the previous slide that newspaper reading is for 1 hour and reading books for 1 hour, grammar is for 1 hour. If you are weak, if you have some kind of knowledge of basic grammar, then you should devote only half an hour. Then reading comprehension for 15 minutes, error spotting for 10 minutes. This is for your exam point of view, that you should devote at least 15 minutes for reading comprehension, 10 minutes for error spotting, para jumble 5 minutes, and close test only for 10 minutes. Okay, so this is 20 and 20, 40 minutes. It means you have 20 minutes more. The more you practice, the more you will gain the speed and accuracy to solve this. Then grammar topics on which error spotting is actually based. These topics are tenses, parts of speech, subject verb agreement, active passive, direct indirect conjunctions and prepositions. These are actually the basics of English grammar, and I have seen that the error spottings are based on these topics only. But due to our lack of knowledge of these topics and the lack of English grammar, we were not able to, or the students find it difficult to attempt the error spotting questions. So you have to prepare these topics very thoroughly and practice them every day to get a command, to get a strong hand on them. Then, what editorial articles help you to do? They build your reading speed. You need to comprehend the passage. It means when you read an editorial article, what do? You just try to write the passage in your own language. That is very important to improve your writing skills as well as the comprehensive abilities. Once you start doing this, your writing abilities will improve. You will get to know that you don't know so many words that you know in Hindi, but you don't know what to say in English, right? You frame the lines yourself, you find the errors, and then you improve. And editorials give you new words to learn. Find out those words, find out the meanings and their synonyms, then use them at least 5 times a day. If you find one word, there are many formations of a word, like act, activity, action, actively, right? So find out the various formation, use them in your sentences, and you will learn language in a better way. Then spellings are very important. Sometimes you get the spelling test in your exam. So whenever you read editorial articles, read the spellings very carefully, because when you read the spellings carefully, you know what is the correct spelling. But if you don't, you miss them. Sometimes the word is in front of you in the exam and you get confused because you didn't focus on the spellings when you were reading the editorial articles. Clear? So spellings are very important. Then things to keep in mind. I personally recommend, do not be afraid of anything. Not of English, not of, do not be afraid of quantitative aptitude or reasoning, because it is an exam. It is not everything that you need to do in your life, right? So take it easily. Take it easy, take it as an exam only, not as a end of your life. You will succeed if you stay focused. If you don't, if you are not focused, if you are going to be thinking like that, I can't do this, I don't know this topic, I don't know this, that, do. So you are not focused. Your mind keep just distracting. You are just distracted. Don't do that. Clear your doubts always. Whenever you find a doubt in anything, in English grammar or English RC passages or anything, you think that you have some kind of doubt, clear that instantly. Because if you don't clear your doubts, that thing is going to be in your exam and you will regret later. Practice grammar rules, that is very important, and read everything as you are learning English. If you read blogs, if you read newspaper, if you read some kind of messages somewhere, everything is trying to teach you something. So get the maximum knowledge or maximum benefits from everything you read, you see, and just use whenever you can use your skills. That is my suggestions for you. And if you feel like you want to ask something or you want to clarify something, this is the email ID you need to drop your doubts to. And this is our WhatsApp group number. For the students who enrolled for the 60-day English grammar course, basic to advanced English course. And if you are not a student or the student who enrolled for the course, you can call us on 99149 68671. Thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.